Okay, guys, so I will help you for all of the questions, but I will help a little bit. Yeah, for number one, find the first four term in the expansion of 2 plus x squared to the power of 6. Okay, 2, itu ada plusnya, itu salah soal ya. 2 plus x squared to the power of 6. When you expand binomial, that means you have to write the C. Yep, remember that? You have to write the C. Starting with 6C0, and then 6C1, and then 6C2, and then 6C3, right? 6C0, 6C1, 6C2, 6C3. Or maybe you can use this notation also, 6C0, and then 6C1 is the same. Yeah? The first four terms, that means we stop at 6C3, 1, 2, 3, 4, four terms. And the next is the term. The first term is 2. 2, 2, 2. And the next one is x squared. X squared, x squared, x squared, and x squared. There you go. Okay, now the powers. I want to ask you for the powers. For the powers of 2, we start from, for the powers of 2, we start from 6 or 0. Start from 6. 6. Okay, good. 6, and then 5, and then 4, and then 3. Very good. For the x squared, start from the opposite, yeah, 0, 0. Okay, so 0, 1, apa? Loncat-loncat, yeah. 1, 2, and 3. There you go. This is the answer for number 1i. Is it hard? No, yeah. It's very easy. And you already got 3 points, guys. It's very easy. Okay, I will give you like 5 minutes to calculate it with your calculator. Dah, okay. Next is II, guys. One II. For the II, you have to multiply. We have multiplication. The multiplication of 2 plus x squared to the power of 6 times with 1 minus 3 over x squared to the power of 2. Okay. What do you do is you have to expand the. Actually, you have to expand them. But for the 2 plus 2x squared, we already got it. The answer for number 1i. 1i, yeah. The answer of 1i, you only have to copy the answer. 2, 1ii. And then times it with the expansion of 1 minus 3 over x squared squared. Times it with this one. Nah, yang ini kita harus cari sendiri, guys. For this one, we have to find it first. 1 minus 3 over x squared squared. Manually. Manually. What do you do? What do you do? 1 minus 3 over x squared. Square means you have to capit kepiting. Ya, capit kepiting. Yo. 1 times 1 equals to 1. And then minus 3 over x squared minus 3 over x squared become what? Minus 3 over x squared minus 3 over x squared. What is the result? The result? Negative 6 over x squared, very good. Negative 6 over x squared. And then the last one is this times this. Negative 3 over x squared times with negative 3 over x squared. What is the result? Negative times negative, positive, of course. And the result will be 9 over x to the power of 4. Very good. And then after this, the question wants you to find the independent of x. Yeah, independent of x. So I believe that you only have a numbers right here. And then you will have x square right here. And then you will have x to the power of 4. And the last one is x to the power of 6. Am I right? Yeah, the question only wants you to find the independent of x. Do you know what is the meaning of independent of x? The independent of x. What is the meaning of independent? Ada yang tahu? Independent. The terms without x. Independent itu artinya the terms without x. So you have to find the multiplication that give us a term without x. Yang mana kali yang mana? Coba. Ini nggak enak ya lihat kayak gini. Ada yang udah dapat jawaban nomor 1i? 1i, ada yang udah dapat jawabannya? Ya, 1i? Ya, berapa? Slowly. 64 plus? Ya? 92 x squared, 240x to the power of 4, yes, last one, 160 x to the power of 6, okay, good, so you have 64, and then 192, 240 and 160, yeah. If you have different answer, just ask me. I will help you. I will check it for you why you got different answer. Yeah. So go back to the definition of independent of x. That means you have to multiply. Yeah, you have to find the multiplication of them that will give you the terms, a term without x. Yeah, kira-kira yang mana kali yang mana? Darren mungkin mau jawab, Darren? Yang mana kali yang mana biar nggak ada x-nya, Darren? Yang menghasilkan nggak ada x-nya. Yang mana aja, Darren?
64 times 1.
64 times 1, very good. Next, ada lagi nggak, Darren?
192 x squared times 6 per x squared.
Ya, oke. Okay. Satu lagi, Nadia, deh. Nah, ada satu lagi, Nat. Which one?
240x4
times with this one. Yeah. Ya, betul. Udah. Nanti kalau udah dapat, that is the answer. Ya, masih gampang ya number 1 ya. Okay, so this is the complete answer for number 1. You can take a screenshot for Nadia and Darren if you want. Tapi kalau udah screenshot tetap harus bikin ya. Yang di sekolah tulis aja. A little way. Udah semua? Ada yang belum number one? Udah semua? Okay, let's take a look at number two. I will give you some hints for number two, guys. The point A, where x equals to 0, lies on the curve y equals to blah, blah, blah. Find the equation of this normal. Yeah? So the keyword is normal, guys. Normal line. If you read normal line, that means you have to know what is the step to find normal line. Ada yang ingat? Langkah satu apa? The first step. What is the first step to find normal line? Normal line and tangent line. Yo, ada yang ingat nggak? Number one. Number one, normal line. Nggak ada yang ingat? Nggak ada yang ingat. Okay, so the first thing you have to do is find y-axis. Y-axis. Do you know what is y-axis? What is y-axis? I think this is Memroot lesson ya. Yeah? Y-axis. Baru. Baru belajar kan? Y-axis, benar? What is it? If yes, differentiation. So you have to find y-axis. Y-axis is the differentiation of y. Jadi langkah pertama kamu harus cari y-axisnya dulu, ya. Langkah dua, the next step will be after differentiate, find gradient, gradient of tangent. You have to find the gradient of tangent. Gradient of tangent means m equals to f arcsin a. Ya, jadi x-nya masukin ke y arcsin. Ya, kalau kamu sering ngerjain ini nanti lama-lama hafal kok, ya. Number three, find the gradient of the normal. Number four, y equals to y minus y1 boleh, m times x minus x1 boleh pakai yang ini, boleh juga y equals to mx plus c, up to you. Yeah, so this is the step to find normal line. You have to memorize them when you read normal line. Atau belum diajarin? Udah belum? You remember? You don't remember ya? Udah belum? I think it's in Memroot. Oh iya, yeah, sorry. Memroot ajarin dy dx. Okay, no problem. Dy over dx, bisa. It's the same. Dy over dx. Ini pada geleng-geleng kepala, kenapa sih? What's wrong? Huh? You haven't learned this yet? If you haven't, maybe we should skip this question. But I think Memroot already set this practice to be similar with the mock exam. So I think it will be comes out at the mock exam. In the mock exam. Ya, kayaknya sih keluar. Harusnya sih, ini tuh chapter berapa ya di buku ya? It's like 20 kalau nggak salah. 20 or 18. Nggak ada yang ingat satu pun? Oh, baru chapter 17? Oh, tapi kok udah dikasih ya? Ya. Oh iya, benar. Yang normal itu formulanya m normal equals to negative 1 over m tangent. Yang normal itu formulanya m normal equals to negative 1 over m tangent, ya. Baru masukin ke sana. Belum? F aksen A-nya belum. Oh, itu mah tinggal dimasukin aja. Okay. I will give you the step ya. First, dy over dx. Take a look at this, guys. dy over dx, that means you have to differentiate the function. Take a look at the function, 4x minus 1 over x minus 1. Can you differentiate it directly? 4x minus 1 over x minus 1. Or is it normal differentiation, or we should use certain formula? Certain formula, what is the formula? Harus diapalin ya, Okay, you have to memorize the formula. Okay, so the formula is when you have y equals to 4x minus 1 over x minus 1, that means you have to use the u over v. Do you remember this? U over v, yes? What is the formula? Dy over dx equals to u accent v minus u v accent over v square, right? Right? Okay, let's try to find the u accent and the v accent. What do you think? The differentiation of u, u accent, 4x minus 1 differentiated into 4. Yes, very good. It become 4, and then 4x minus 1 differentiate into 1. Okay, very good. Nggak di rumah, nggak di sekolah ya. Kalau di rumah itu, ya anak-anak apa? Chat semua ya. Kalau di sekolah, ya anak-anak tetap nggak mau ngomong gitu. Kenapa? Why? Harus ngomong ya, punya mulut kan? Ya ngomong. Justru enaknya ke sekolah tuh gitu ya, kita bisa communicate ya. Dy over dx equals to u accent v minus u accent over v square. Come on guys. Put the u accent and v accent, also u and v, to the formula. Yang di rumah juga ikutan ya, Nadia, Darren. Follow the step. Okay, so if you are correct, you will get 4 times x minus 1 minus 4x minus 1 times with 1 over x minus 1 square, right? Okay, here's the trick. Do not simplify this. Do not simplify this. Not do not, yeah. I'm not recommend to simplify this because this is not the questions. This is not the questions, right? Just leave it like that and then move on to the next step. The next step, gradient of tangent. This is the first step. And this is the next step. You have to find the gradient of the tangent line. Gradient of tangent line, what do you do is you only have to put the value of x. Yeah, the value of x into the dy over dx. So we already have dy over dx. That means we have the gradient of tangent by substituting the x. Let's look at the question. What is the value of x in the question? Huh? Zero. Very good. So you put zero into the x. 4 times zero minus 1 times 1. We don't have to write times 1 ya. Yeah? Zero minus 1 square. Nah ini. F aksen A itu maksudnya kayak gini guys. This is the notation. And what do you do is only substitute the x. Ya. Yeah? Jadi itu memang nggak diajarin. Kalau kalian nggak tahu F aksen X ya nggak apa-apa lah ya. Yang penting kalian tahu langkahnya yang selanjutnya itu find the gradient of tangent. Okay? Dah, this is the second, ya. Yeah. Ada dari soal, where x equals to 0. If the question says where x equals to 1, you should substitute the x with 1 and so on. Okay? Can you understand that? Next, what is the result? Negative 4 plus 1, negative 3 ya. Negative 3 over 1, negative 3. Am I right? Negative 3? Negative 3, okay. So this is the second step. The third step is find the gradient of normal. We know that tangent and normal is perpendicular. Because they are perpendicular, that means we have to use the formula of gradient of perpendicular lines. The formula is actually like this. m1 times m2 equals to negative 1. Yeah, but I modified the formula, and actually in your book also, they modified the formula into the gradient of normal equals to negative 1 over gradient of tangent. So you will get gradient of normal equals to 1 over 3, right? Yeah, can you understand this? Am I too fast? No? Okay, next is number 4. Number 4 is the question. Find the equation of the normal. The equation of the normal means you have to use one of these formula. Biasanya kalian kayak mana? Yang satu yang the point. I'm using Wi-Fi. Okay, good. So we don't have the point, but we can find the point from the questions, right? The question tell us the value of x. We already have x equals to 0. That means we have to find the y. Y equals to 4x minus 1 over x minus 1. Okay, and then substitute the x, you'll get y equals to negative 1 over negative 1, y equals to 1. 4 times 0 minus 1 over 0 minus 1. You'll get 1, yeah, 1. That means the coordinate is 0, 1. After you get the coordinates, you can find the c easily. You can find the C easily using the points 0, 1. 1 equals to 1 over 3 times 0 plus C. C equals to 1. And therefore, the equation will be 1 over 3x plus 1. There you go. This is the simplest step to find normal and also tangent. Yeah, and also tangent. When the question says, find the tangent, that means you have to stop at step number 2 and then continue to step number 4. Oh no, that means you have to skip step number 3. Just skip number 3 if the question asks you for the tangent, not normal. Yeah, take notes, guys. Yeah, so tangent and normal also common questions in AGCST. Yeah, so I think you should master this step 1, 2, 3, 4. For tangent, skip step number 3. Okay. Next is number 3. For number 3, we have unit circle. Yeah, unit circle. The thing you have to remember in unit circle is triangle formula for trigonometry, like cosine rule, sine rule, and also area. Yeah. So these 3, you have to memorize for the unit circle. Sine rule, cosine rule, sine rule, and also area of triangle. area of triangle. Okay, cos rule formulanya apa? A square equals to B square plus C square minus 2BC cos A. And sine rule is A over sine A. Itu terbalik nggak apa-apa ya. Mau sine A di atas juga nggak apa-apa. Over sine B. And the area is area equals to half times B times C times sine A. Nah, kayak gini ya. Formulanya kalian harus hafal tiga-tiganya. Dan juga formula untuk area of sector. Area of sector. Area of sector is half pi. Oh, sorry, half theta r square, and the formula for the apa ya arc length for the arc length is s ya, s equals to theta r. And remember, please remember this ya, the theta have to be in radian. It cannot be in degree, ya. Yeah. It should be in radian. Have to be, not should be. Have to be in radian. Okay, so this is the preparation for number three. Take a look at number three. The diagram shows a circle, center O, radius A, the points P and Q and blah 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 blah. The angle is 3π/4, and also PP is a tangent. Okay, so this tangent is very important, guys. PT and QT are tangents. What do you think? What is the question try to tell you with this sentence? Tangent. Yeah? Sorry, I cannot hear you clearly. What does it say? Can you hear? No. Okay. Louder. Right angle, very good. Yeah, right angle. Okay. Itu double sih, jadi ketutup. Okay, no problem. So right angle, yes, very good. If you read tangent, that means in unit circle, yeah. That means the question trying to tell you that this is right angle, guys. You have to know that this is right angle. Okay. After that, we can separate the shapes into two parts. Because you have right angle, that means usually you separate the quadratics into two parts. So we will have triangle, and that is special triangle, right triangle. Okay, next. And usually if you have right triangle, you don't have to use this formula. Ya, nggak usah pakai ini. Kamu pakai formula cosine rule, sine rule, and area. Itu kalau triangle-nya itu bukan right angle. Tapi kalau right angle nggak usah, ya. Okay, let's try to find the length of PT. Somebody, can you find PT? So because we divide the quadratics into two parts, quadrilateral into two parts, that means the angle also divided into two parts. Ya, yang tadinya 3π/4 radian divided into two parts, jadi berapa? 3π/8, very good. So one of them is 3π/8, and also the other one is 3π/8. Dah? Nah, kalau udah, you can find PT easily. Any idea how to find PT? Any idea how to find PT, guys? PT. Apa yang bisa kamu pakai? Ya, tangent, very good. Normal tangent, right? Yang apa? Yang tangent biasa ya, tangent biasa. So we can write it like this. Tan 3π. Tan 3π/8 radians equals to the opposite side. You don't know yet, which is PT, opposite over adjacent. And what is the adjacent? 8 centimeters, very good. And be careful guys, when you using your calculator and you want to press sine, cos, and tangent, be careful, you have to set up the unit of angle first. For this one, what is the unit? Radian. That means you have to set up your calculator into radian. Yeah. Come on, set up it first. Only when you press sine, cos, and tangent, ya. Biasanya kalian bingung, kapan ya I harus set up, kapan enggak gitu ya. When you want to press sign, nah itu otaknya itu langsung, oh, I harus set up gitu, ya. When you want to press 10, nah itu kamu harus udah langsung, oh, saya harus set up. Sesuai sama soalnya. Kalau soalnya radian, kamu set up-nya radian. Kalau soalnya degree, kamu set up-nya degree. Oke, okay, dapatnya berapa PT-nya? Ada yang udah dapat? Nadia mungkin? Darren?
Not yet, sir.
Not yet? Oke, okay, just use your calculator ya. 10, 3 pi over 8-nya jangan lupa dikurungin di dalam calculator-nya. 3 pi over 8 inside the brackets ya. 10, 3 pi over 8. Oh, ya. Yeah. Final answer in three significant figures. Also. Okay, also. Always. Always. Dapat berapa, Jason? 19.3. 19.3. Centimeter, ya. Centimeter. Ada yang beda? Let me check. 10, 3 pi. Oh, by the way, you can write pi in your calculator, ya. Do not write 22 over 7, 3.14. Don't. Just write pi. Ya, press the pi button in your calculator. 3 pi over 8 times with 8. And the question is, the answer is 19.3. Very good. 19.3. Udah dapat semua? Bennett, dapat nggak, Ben? Belum? Bennett, ini kayak gini nih, Ben. 10, 3 pi over 8 equals to PT over 8. Then you cross multiply. In your calculator, you will write like this. 10, harus pintar pakai calculatornya ya, biar bisa hemat waktu guys. Di exam nanti, hemat waktu itu penting banget. Jadi kalian jangan tulis semua. Ya, langsung aja, kalau kayak gini kamu nggak usah langsung, kalau kamu nggak usah tulis 8 kali itu dulu, nggak usah. Langsung aja di calculator. Nanti kamu langsung dapat PT-nya. PT equals to 19.3. Very good. Next is find the area of the shaded region. Shaded region means you have to find the area of the triangle first. The big triangle, the yellow triangle. Let's look at the triangles. You have the yellow triangle and it is special triangle, right? Right angle. That means you can use this formula for the II. Area of triangle equals to half times base times height. Yeah. The simplest formula for area of triangle, half times base times height. And the question is, base-nya berapa? Height-nya berapa? Base-nya berapa? Height-nya berapa? Height-nya berapa ya? 19.3 for the base, yes, you can say 19.3 for the base. If the 19.3 is the base, then the height is 8. Very good. Therefore, you will get the area of triangle times 8 equals to 77.2 centimeter square. This is the area of one triangle. Yeah. Do not multiply by 2 first, but instead, let's try to find the area of sector. Area of sector tuh yang mana sih? The area of this one nih. Nah, yang kayak gini, yang kayak pizza, guys. Ya, the one like pizza. Nah, ini formulanya apa? Area of sector equals to half times theta times radius square. Half times theta. What is the theta? 3 pi over 8, very good. 3 pi over 8 times the radius. 8 square. Oh ya, yeah, actually ini saya ajarin juga cara pakai kalkulatornya ya. Cara pakai kalkulatornya itu kalian bisa pencet yang gini nih, kotak per kotak. Jadi kalian jangan kaliin atasnya dulu, kaliin bawahnya dulu, jangan yang lama, belum ceroboh salah pencet lagi. Di kalkulatornya benar-benar semuanya harus ditulis kayak gini langsung. Belajar ya, belajar tulis kayak gini langsung. 3 pi over 8. Oh, karena I cuma mau cari yang atasnya aja. Bukan mau cari semua, cari yang atasnya aja. Kalau mau cari semua bisa pakainya 3 pi over 4. Ya, yeah, you can do that also. Ya, yeah, 3 pi over 8 times 8 square. Ya, yeah, kamu tulis di kalkulatornya harus satu gini, satu blok gitu. Biar cepat, guys. Half times 3 pi over 8 times 8 square equals to 37.699111 ya. Because this is not the final answer, just leave it like that. And then what do you do? What do you do is you have to find this one. This one, this shaded region, half of it. Ya, setengahnya dulu. Caranya gimana? Caranya segitiga yang tadi dikurangin area of sector. So area of the green one, the green will be 77.2 minus 37.69911. Ya, berapa tuh? 39.5, three significant figures, centimeter square, and then times it by 2. Ya, dikali 2. Kenapa dikali 2? Karena tadi kita baru ngitung setengahnya ya, baru yang atasnya aja. Ya, cari yang bawahnya ya kali 2. Area of the shaded region equals to 39.5 times 2. 79.0 centimeter square. And this is the answer. 79.0 centimeter square. Itu baru yang II ya. Sekarang yang perimeter, guys. Perimeter ya. II. Yo, I will wait for you to take note. Nah, okay, the third one, the perimeter of the shaded region. Okay, for perimeter, you only have to find this. You have to find the arc length. The arc length for this one. The arc length of PQ. The arc length means S equals to theta times R. S equals to theta times R. S equals to 3 pi over 4. Times the radius. The radius is 8. And that means you have 6 pi. Yeah, you can leave it like this, or you can calculate it with your calculator. How much is 6 pi? 6 pi is 18.85 centimeter. So this is the S. After you get the S, the perimeter means you have to add all of the edge. Ya, kamu tambahin semua edges-nya. Ya, kamu tambahin PQ, and then you can add the PQ with PT, and then after that TQ. Ya, you will get the perimeter. So the perimeter will be perimeter of the shaded region will be 18.85 plus the PQ. Sorry, the PT. The PT is 19.3 times 2, yeah, times 2 for the TQ because PT and TQ is the same. Nanti kalian dapat 18.5 plus 19.3 times 2, 57.1. Yeah, this is how you solve number 3. How many numbers do we have? 10, ya? Baru 3 ini. 1 hour to 3, ya? And the next will be vector. Vector kalian baru belajar, ya? Baru belajar, harusnya sih bisa. Seven point one, yes. Huh? Oh, ada yang salah. Ya, betul. 45. Run it off. It will be 57.5. Yeah. Okay. I think that's it for today. We only have 5 minutes left. I don't think we can do one more questions. We can take a break. Earlier, thank you for Darren and Nadia. Nadia, we'll meet again later, yeah, Sunday. If you can, please join Darren. Yeah, the extra lesson later on Sunday. Okay, and Nadia also. Yeah, bye.
Thank you, sir.
Ya, Nadia. Selamat. Ya, you're welcome, Jared.
Okay, I'm ready. Let's go, guys. Number. Any specific numbers that you want to ask? No? Okay, let's discuss all of the numbers. Number 4 is about vector. You recently learned about vectors, right? So I think you have to be able to solve this. 4a, the four points OA, OB, OC are such that OA equals to 5a, OB equals to 15b, and OC equals to 24b minus 3a. Show that B lies on the line AC. Okay, B lies on the line AC. What is that means? Yeah. So we have a line AC. I have a line of AC right like this. So this is the line of AC. Okay, and the question wants you to prove that B lies on this line. So the question says B is right here. Yeah, how to solve this? Take a look at the A, B, and C. What is the relationship between A, B, and C, guys? Oh, belum share screen. Udah belum? Can you see my share screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, what is the relationship between point A, point B, and point C? Somebody. I already teach you this like last week gitu ya. Last week yang I tinggalin kalau nggak salah. Nonton video. They are collinear points, right? They are collinear points. if you have collinear points, that means there are certain condition that you have to fulfill the collinear, yeah, which is AB equals to K times BC. Or you can say AB equals to K times AC also. Ya, mau yang mana aja boleh. Ya, yang penting kalau kolinear itu kalian harus pakai rumusnya kayak gini. AB equals to K times BC or AB equals to K times AC. Ya, mau pakai yang mana aja boleh. So, let's say I will choose AC. So, this is the condition for collinear. Ya. Please remember that. Collinear. Okay. So, AB. What is the formula for AB? Of course, OB minus OA equals to K times AC, OC minus OA. And then, next, what do you do? Of course, you put the OB and put the OA into the equations. 15B minus 5A equals to K times OC, 24B minus 3A, and then minus 5A, like this. B, A, B, A, A. And then after that, you can simplify the AC. So you will get 15B minus 5A equals to K times, how about this, negative, sorry, 24B minus 8A. There you go. So, after this, what do you do to prove that B lies on the line AC? To prove, yeah, collinear. Collinear means K times. That means you have to find the value of K satisfies this equation. If you can find the K, that means it is collinear. But if you cannot find the value of K, that means the three points is not collinear. Yeah. Ada nggak nilai K yang bisa kalian dapetin? Gimana cara dapetin nilai K-nya, guys? Ada yang tahu nggak nilai K-nya berapa? Waduh, ini masih... ada di itu gitu, chat box. I cannot see the chat box, ya. So, I think you should unmute your microphone. It's a little bit hard to see the chat box in Google Meet. So, please unmute your microphone if you want to answer. Ada yang dapat nggak? K-nya berapa, guys? K-nya berapa? By the way, I already record the meetings, ya. So, later I will give you the video. Nggak ada yang tahu? Gimana caranya? Okay, so first, I want you to take a look at the B. We have 15 equals to K times 24, right? For the B. So I will get K equals to 15 over 24. So the K will be divided by 3, 5 over 8. So this is the first K from B. After that, let's check the A. Yeah, for the A, we have negative 5 equals to negative 8k. So from the A, I also got k equals to 5 over 8. So as you can see, the value of k is the same. That means this value of k is satisfy the condition. And also, if the k is satisfy the condition, you can tell that B, so the conclusion is B lies on AC. There you go. So take a look at the step. First, you read lies on line. Lies on line means collinear. Collinear means this condition. This condition, you will get K. And then if the K is satisfied, you can tell that B lies on AC. Gitu. Ya. Ngerti nggak ini? Can you understand this? Kenapa pada diam, guys? Ayo, ini kan bukan sekolah. Kalau bukan sekolah kan kita santai aja, ya. Santai aja. Nah, ini jawaban yang A, guys. Sudah terbukti, ya. Kalau ada yang nggak ngerti nanti boleh tanya ya, boleh tanya lagi. Jangan malu-malu guys, harus tanya. If you cannot understand what I'm saying, you have to ask me. Ya, I will explain to you until you understand. Number B. B, relative to an origin O, the position factor of P. Ya, read this. Read relative to an origin O, the position factor of P. That means the question tells you OP. OP equals to I n negative 4j. I nggak terlalu suka pakai I sama j ya. Jadi I biasanya ubah jadi 1 sama negative 4. Tapi kalau yang ini tadi nggak boleh. Karena ini bukan I and j. This is A and B. Itu nggak boleh diginiin ya. Nggak boleh diginiin. Yang boleh dijadiin vektor kolom itu cuman yang I sama yang j aja. And I want you to read this one. Position factor of point Q. That means OQ. OQ is 3 and 7. Find the length of PQ. You know that this bracket means length, right? The magnitude of the factors. To find the magnitude of the factors, of course, you have to find the factor itself. So first, we will not find the magnitude, but the factor first. PQ. PQ equals to? Somebody help me. I forget the formula. PQ equals to? Rumus sakti guys di bab ini apa?
OQ minus OP.
Okay, very good. OQ minus OP. Very good. And then substitute the number. The OQ is 37 and the OP is 1 minus 4. And you will get 2 and also 11. Okay. This is the factor of PQ, and then after that, you can find the magnitude. To find the magnitude, you will use Pythagoras, right? Pythagoras of 2 square and 11 square. And the result is 1 to 5, 1 to 1 and 5, and 4, 1 to 5, yeah? 1 to 5 means 5 square root of 5 units. You can answer it like that. Or maybe you can use your calculator to convert it into decimal. But do not forget when you convert it into decimal, you should answer in 3 significant figures. Okay, next the II. The II is unit factors, guys. Unit factor of PQ itu lambangnya kayak gini, kasih topi. Nah, kalau dikasih topi, bukan tanda panah lagi, itu artinya udah unit factor. Does somebody know what is the formula for unit factor? Ada yang masih ingat unit factor formulanya apa? Unit factor? Nggak tahu? Oke, kalau nggak tahu rumusnya itu the factor divided by the magnitude. Ya, you should remember, you should memorize all of the formula. The factors, PQ. PQ means this one, right? This one. This one is PQ. So I will write for unit factors, you don't have any other option. You have to use I and J. I plus 11J. Yeah? You cannot use column factor in a unit factor. Divided by the magnitude. The magnitude itu yang tadi kita dapat. 5 square root of 5. 5 square root of 5. There you go. This is the unit factor. Any questions for I and II? Before we go to III, III is a little bit hard. Any questions? No. Okay, good. So now we have point M, the position factor of M. Okay, so we have point M, guys. We have PQ, point P, and point Q. And then we have the midpoint of PQ, which is point M. Yeah. For this one, you can use the formula of the midpoint coordinates. Do you still remember what is the formula for midpoint coordinates? Midpoint coordinates. Midpoint. X1 plus X2 over 2. Y1 plus Y2 over 2. Gitu. Ya. Jadi kita hitung m in the brackets. So what is the x1 and what is the x2? X1 is the coordinates for p, and x2 is the coordinate of q. But the question is, kita punya nggak point p itu koordinatnya berapa? Point q koordinatnya berapa? Kita punya nggak sih? Do we have the coordinates of p and q? Punya nggak? Somebody? Punya nggak? Punya nggak? Punya nggak? Punya? Guys, guys. Halo, halo. Masa lupa
ada,
semua?
Sir. Ada, sir.
Ada. Jawabannya ada. OP. Remember this? Ya, OP. Position vector itu bisa dianggap sebagai point. Ingetin itu ya, ingetin itu. Jadi kalau kamu punya OP, berarti kamu punya coordinates of P. Harus hafal. Kalau kamu punya OQ, berarti kamu udah punya point Q. Nah, OP-nya itu 1, negative 4. Berarti coordinates of P-nya itu negative 1, sorry. 1, negative 4. Nggak ada bedanya sama position vector. Karena position vector itu melambangkan coordinates-nya. Q juga sama. Q is 3,7. Itu. Jadi kita bisa pakai formula ini untuk dapat M. Ya, yuk kita masukin. 1 plus 3 over 2. And then negative 4 plus 7 over 2. And the answer is 2,3 over 2. But this is the coordinates. The question wants you to find the position vector, not the coordinate. So you have to convert this point into position vector. Tadi I bilang, point itu sama persis sama position vectornya. Jadi kamu jawab, OM, the position vector of M, equals to 2 and 3 over 2. Selalu sama-sama poinnya, guys. Nggak akan beda angkanya, selalu sama. Ya. So this is number 4. All of the number 4. Any questions? All of number 4 from 4A and then 4B. 4B we have 3 questions and the total mark is 4, 7, 8. 8 marks, yeah. Any questions? No? Okay, good. So number 5. For number 5, take a look at this. For number 5, let's discuss. Let's do this together, okay? Tan theta plus cos theta over 1 plus sin theta equals to secant theta. You have to show that. Please remember that when you when the question wants you to show something, that means you pretend that you don't have this one. Yeah, you don't know the answer. And when you calculate the left side, the answer should be secant theta later, yeah. But now, for now, we pretend we don't know the answer. The secant theta, we don't know the secant theta. Yeah, just do the left side. Okay, let's do this. Tan theta, any idea how to solve this? Yeah, how to apa? Simplify the expressions. How to simplify the expressions? Any idea, guys? Somebody? No? Any idea? So you have the identity, right? Do you still remember the identity? Tan theta equals to?
Sin over cos.
Yeah, sin over cos. So you already know sin over cos. Very good. I think for this one, yeah, if you have questions about identity of three geometry, you have to convert it into sin and cos. Yeah, do not use tan. Yeah, tan is uncommon. The common things is sin and cos. Okay, so you have to change this tan into sin theta. It will be more easier. Trust me. Cos theta. And then plus for this one, cos theta over 1 plus sin theta. So this form Yeah, is a special form. I call this special form. Why? Because sering banget ini keluar. Ya. Usually when the questions like this comes out, students didn't know what to do. Don't know what to do. Yeah, jadi I will call this as a special expressions. When you find a special expressions like this, what do you have to do is times it with, take a look at this, 1 plus sine theta. If you have 1 plus sine theta, that means you have to times it with 1 minus sine theta. You will know the reason later. Yeah, I will tell you the reason why we have to multiply it with 1 minus theta. 1 minus sine theta. But you have to memorize this first. Okay? When you have this kind of questions, you have to times it with that. If you have this type of questions, 1 minus cos theta over sine theta. Ya. Di atasnya cos, di bawahnya sin. Jadi ciri khasnya tuh gitu. Ada satunya, ada kurang atau tambahnya. Ini bisa cos, bisa sin. Terserah soalnya ya. Kamu harus kaliin. Kalau yang ini dikali apa? Times with? Ada yang tahu? Dikali apa? One? Halo, guys? Ini kenapa pada malu-malu semua ya? Sine plus theta. One plus sine theta. I cannot read the chat, guys. Karena chatnya nggak bisa dikeluarin. Kalau Zoom kan bisa dikeluarin ya. I can put the chat in the top corner left atau apa, I bisa baca. Tapi kalau Google Meet agak susah, I harus pindah window dulu baru kebaca gitu. Jadi kalau bisa unmute guys. Nah, salah, sorry. Ya ini dikalinya 1 plus cos theta ya. 1 plus cos theta, 1 plus cos theta. Oke. Nah, nanti kalau kalian udah sering ngerjain soal IGCSE, ini tuh lumayan sering keluar. Nanti kalian terbiasa sendiri. Ya, oke. Nah, ini kita kaliin yuk. Yang sebelah kiri biarin dulu. Sin theta over cos theta. Leave it like that. And then for the right one, you will multiply the bottom, not the top. You will leave the top like this. Leave it like that. And then for the bottom part, you can do capit kepiting. Yeah. When you capit kepiting, you will get 1 minus sin square theta. Now, this is the reason. This is the reason why we have to times it with this one. The reason is this one. Do you know what is this? 1 minus sine square theta. Alasannya tuh biar ini yang muncul, guys. Biar 1 min sin theta, sin kuadrat thetanya tuh kita punya gitu. Kenapa kita harus munculin ini? Karena kita because we have another identity, right? Besides tan, we have what identity? What else? Ada yang tahu? Selain tan, sin square theta plus cos square theta equals to 1, right? Harus hafal ya, harus hafal. Nah, when you move the sin square theta, you will get cos square theta equals to 1 minus sin square theta. Nah, ini alasannya. Alasannya apa? Biar bisa diganti. Biar ini tuh bisa berubah. Berubah jadi apa? Jadi cos square theta, guys. Equals to sin theta over cos theta plus cos theta 1 minus sin theta over, for the bottom part, we can change them into cos square theta. Can you understand this? Am I too fast? No? Okay, good. Next is we can cross out the cos theta. Satu biji, ya. Jadi kita punya denominatornya itu over cos theta. Lihat, di sini over cos theta, di sini over cos theta. Berarti udah bagus banget ya. We have the same denominator. That means we can add them together. How to add them together? For the top part, we have sin theta, plus 1 minus sin theta over cos theta, right? Sin theta minus sin theta equals to 0. So it will leave us cos theta. And 1 over cos theta equals to secant theta. There you go. Our answer is secant theta And the question wants you to show that this one is equal to secant theta. Secant theta and secant theta is the same, so we have proof. Gitu guys, nomor 5. Ayo guys, saya ajak kalian meeting itu untuk itu ya, untuk diskusi. Dengan kalian diskusi itu sama kayak menghafal guys. Kalau kaliannya diem aja, saya doang yang ngomong, nggak ada bedanya sama nonton video ya. Nonton video itu kekurangannya kalian nggak bisa ngomong, nggak bisa nanya, nggak bisa ikut jawab ya. Kalau ikut jawab, kata saya paling penting tuh ikut jawab guys. Kalau kalian ikut jawab ya, itu sama aja kayak apa ya, kayak nginget caranya gimana. Dengan kalian menjawab, nanti kalau dapat pertanyaan kayak gini lagi, kalian pasti bisa jawab lagi kan. Tapi kalau kaliannya diam aja, nanti dapat soal kayak gini mungkin lupa. Gitu. Jadi ayo dong, aktif ya. Nah ini caranya. Nomor 5 guys. Any questions? No? Oke, okay, next. Nomor 6 ya. Number 6, find the set value of K does not intersect. Oke, number 6. Nah, ini bahan SMP, guys. Kalau yang tadi, ini trigonometri bahan SMA ya, kalau nggak salah ya. Semester 1 ya. Yang ini vektor baru aja belajar. Terus, kemarin apa ya? Kemarin bahan SMP semua sih. Kecuali binomial theorem ya, baru belajar. Oke, yuk, number 6. Find the set of value of K, which line does not intersect the curve. Does not intersect. Ya, so the keyword is this. Does not intersect. Tapi keyword yang pertama sebenarnya intersect guys. If you have two function and then the question say intersect, what do you have to do? So we have these two function, right? The green one. Do not read the question first. Find the set value of K. Itu later. Ya, itu dibacanya terakhir, guys. Yang kita baca itu pertama fungsinya ada dua. Kemudian ada kata kunci intersect. What do you do when you read intersect and you have two curve? Two function. What do you do? Ada yang tahu nggak? Satu anak aja. Please. Satu anak aja. Please.
Sir,
ya apa
yang
tadi? Ya.
K
yang quadratic equationnya di equal sama
ya betul K betul tinggi. Di okay. Sama denganin ya teman kamu bilang katanya di sama denganin ya metodenya tuh namanya substitution guys when you have word intersect ya tulisin ya intersect that means substitute mau intersect apapun itu pasti substitute. Substitute. Apa sih? Susah ya. Tunggu. Konsentrasi. Substitute. Am I right? Substitute. Ya betul. Oke, ya gitulah ya. Substitute. Ya, jadi kita harus substitute. Substitute-nya apa? Karena kita punya two curve and they are intersect, that means we have to substitute one of them into another. So let's write one of them. Let's say y equals to k times 4x minus 3. So this one is the first curve, the line, right? When we substitute, that means we have to put this one, into the y. Yeah, because y equals to 4x squared plus 8x minus 8. That means this y can be substituted into 4x squared plus 8x minus 8. Equals to 4kx minus 3k. Let's multiply the k like this. After that, we know that this one is a quadratic equation, right? Quadratic equation have to be equal to zero. Yeah, we cannot compromise. It has to be equal to zero. So we will move the right side into the left side. 8x minus 4kx minus 8 plus 3k equals to 0. And we cannot simplify them. Just leave them like that. So we already use the word intersect, right? Now, the second keyword, which is does not intersect. Does not intersect. What does it mean? Does not intersect. Have another words, which is no solution, right? Why we can say that is no, there is no solution? Because they doesn't intersect. They are not intersecting each other. So we will not get the solution. No solution. Ada kata lain ya. No real roots. Ada yang ingat sesuatu? That means we have a formula guys for this one. No solution. No real roots. In quadratic equation, what is the formula? Somebody, satu orang aja, please. Ada yang ingat enggak? Ada yang ingat enggak? Guys. Enggak ada yang ingat satupun. Gimana dong? Besok gimana tesnya? Mungkin exam-nya bahaya, ini bahaya. Gimana? No solution, no real roots, that means?
B square minus 4AC larger than 0. B square minus 4AC larger than 0.
Tapi bukan larger ya, less than ya.
Oh ya, yeah, less than.
Less than. Okay, so we have three formula, right? The formula is B square minus 4AC greater than 0. B square minus 4AC equals to 0. B square minus 4AC less than 0. You can use this formula if you have quadratic equation. Yeah, please remember that. Quadratic equation. And each of the formula have the meaning. Yeah, itself. For the first one, the meaning is two real solutions. So if you read two real solutions, kamu harus udah ingat, oh ini rumusnya. Two distinct solutions. Sambil dicatat ya kalau butuh ya. Two distinct solution. Itu juga berarti formulanya ini. Begitu kamu baca keyword-keyword ini harus udah langsung otaknya ngarah ke rumus ya. For this one, two equal solution. It can be solution or it can be roots ya, it's the same. Two equal solution or one solution. Itu berarti formulanya ini. For this one, no solution. Nah, ini harus ingat, guys. Ini pelajaran SMP, ya. Jangan dilupain. Dah? Nah, kalau udah baru kita pakai. Does not intersect. Does not intersect means no solution. Means no real roots. Means b square minus 4ac less than 0. Let's use the formula. B square minus 4ac less than 0. B square first. Can you tell me what is the b? B-nya berapa, guys? B-nya yang mana? Which one is B?
8 minus 4K, sir.
8 minus 4K, very good. 8 minus 4K, sir. The coefficient in front of the X, ya. Take a look at the X. Find X. Find X. Oh, this one and this one. That means they are B without the X, ya. Without the X. So we will write 8 minus 4K square minus 4 times A. What is the A? The coefficient of x square, and then what is the c? The constant, yeah, the independent of x, doesn't have x, yeah, berapa aja? Negative 8 plus 3k, and then less than 0. From this, you will get the value of k. But still, it's hard enough to answer, yeah. Let's try to solve, yeah. Ini agak susah, guys. Square it. When you square it, you cannot answer it like this. 64 minus 16k square or plus 16k square. You cannot, ya. Yeah? You have to capit kepiting. Capit kepiting 8 minus 4k times 8 minus 4k, guys. Capit kepiting. You will get 64 minus 32 minus 32 minus 64k. and then plus 16k squared, capit kepiting, and then minus 16 times negative 8 plus 3k. Yeah, I will do this slowly. Negative 16 first, and then rearrange them. 16k squared minus 64k plus 64 plus 80 plus 48, yeah, 80 plus 48, 128, 128, and then minus 48k less than 0, guys. Next step, simplify it. Minus 112k, and then plus 192 equals to, not equals to 0, less than 0. That means we have to divide them by 16 maybe, can it? 7k. How about this? 1, 2, 12, less than 0. Okay, now the next question is, how to solve this? How to solve this? The first step, let's go. What is the first step to solve this inequality? Quadratic inequality, guys, let's go.
Factorize it,
sir. Yeah, factorize it.
Factorize
the k, yeah. Factorize the quadratics, k and k, 5 and 2, minus and minus. You will get the value of k. When you have the value of k, when you write the value of k, please do not write less than. But instead, change it into equal first. Yeah, we will talk about less than later. So, the question is less than, right? Not equal. So we have to do something. We have to create a number line. Number line like this. And then put your k, 2 and 5, on the number line. And then I don't know which method your teacher teach you, ya. Tapi biasanya kalau di IGCSE Cambridge itu metodenya kayak gini, guys. Take a look at the k square. The k square is positive, right? Ya, kenapa?
Kayaknya itu 4 sama 3 deh.
Oh, iya.
Kayaknya itu 4 sama 3 deh. Bukan yang sama 2.
7-nya ya. 7, 5 sama 2. Astaga. 4 sama 3. Oke, okay, thank you. Thank you for the correction. 3 and 4. Oke, okay, thank you. 3 and 4. Oke, okay, good. Next is, take a look at the k square. The k square is positive. Positive means this curve, right? When you have negative, that means that curve. So you have to draw the curve in your number line. So your curve will be like this, yeah, passing through 3 and 4, of course. Okay, can you understand this? And then you have to shade the region which is less than 0. Less than 0 means below the x-axis. Below the x-axis means this region. And this region lies between 3 and 4, right? So this is the value of k. The value of k is between 3 and 4. Be careful with the instruction, yeah. Be careful with the sentence of the questions. Find the set values of k. When you the question say find the set value of k, means you have to answer it like this. But if the question says find one possible value of k, if the question says find one possible value of k, that means you have to answer it like this. K equals to maybe 3.5, or maybe your friend says 3.7. It's all correct. Ya, please, kalau kamu udah dapat jawaban, tolong baca lagi. Please read the questions carefully. Ya, dia maunya apa? Kalau kamu jawab kayak gini, tapi dia tanyanya yang lain, meskipun kamu benar, itu dikurangin poinnya, guys. Okay, this is for number 6. Any questions for number 6? Can you understand this? I don't know whether the questions later in mock exam will be the same or not with this one, because Mem Ruth only give me the exercise. She didn't give me the mock exam question, so I cannot tell you whether it is the same or not, yeah. But I think it will be similar, I think.
Sir?
Ya?
Yeah? Sir? Arah panah.
Berarti arah panah yang
itu apa sih namanya? Wait. Itu apa sih namanya?
Wait. Arah panah teh yang mana?
Yang K E3 is
yang K.
Oh, ini. Ini
smaller than K. Taunya dari mana?
Tahu less than-nya dari mana?
Taunya dari mana?
You mean the shadings, the green one or the notation?
The notation.
Okay, you have to memorize
the
it.
Notation,
first, sir. If you have this type of shadings, one to the left and one to the right, so you will have two type of shading, right? The first one is like this, one to the left and one to the right, and the second one is like this, between. Yeah. So for example, we have 2 and 5. This one also 2 and 5. For the top one, you will write it like this, X, and then X. The X will be separated away. Why? Because we have one to the left and one to the right. So the X should be separated. One to the left, X less than. We know that to the left is less than, right? Less than 2. Or one to the right, that means greater than 5. There you go. It's always like that. One less than and another one is greater than. Selalu kayak gitu. Kalau satu ke kiri, satu ke kanan. Ya, tapi kalau bentuknya kotak kayak gini, kalau bentuknya kotak, itu X-nya di tengah, kejepit antara 2 sama 5. Jadi kamu tulis kayak gini dulu, X-nya di tengah, 2-nya di kiri, 5-nya di kanan. Terus kamu ingetin, kalau kejepit gini, tandanya tuh pasti lebih kecil, nggak mungkin lebih besar. Nggak mungkin satu lebih kecil, satu lebih besar juga nggak mungkin. Pasti lebih kecil ya, percaya deh, trust me. Oke, maksudnya itu?
Yes, sir.
Ya, oke. Okay. Berarti tinggal dihafalin ya. Yes, kamu hafalin kalau bentuknya kotak, cara nulisnya gini. Kalau bentuknya ke kiri satu, ke kanan satu, cara nulisnya gitu. Oke, okay, ada lagi pertanyaan nomor 6?
Sir.
Ya.
Yeah. How do we know kalau kita harus pakai yang how do we know kalau kita harus pakai yang
is
yang itu ada x
atau yang
is
smaller than x
smaller than 2 atau yang 2 is smaller than x terus s is smaller than 5. How do you know?
Dari gambar kamu, dari line number kamu. Kalau number line kamu kayak gini, kayak tadi shading-nya kan yang ini nih. Nah, itu kan berarti between 3 and 4. Kalau between ya berarti gambarnya kotak tuh. Between itu berarti gini, sebenarnya gini sih shading-nya ya. Sebenarnya gini tuh. Between 3 and 4, right? Between 3 and 4 berarti pakainya yang bawah. Nah, tapi I will give you another example ya. So, if you have like x squared minus x minus 6 greater than 0. What do you do? First, you have to factorize. Of course, factorize x, 3, and 2. And then minus and plus, you will get x equals to 3, x equals to negative 2, right? Let's practice, guys. All of you. Let's practice with me. So, after we factorize, you will write x equal to 3, ya. Not x greater than 3. Jangan mentang-mentang ininya greater than, kamu tulis di sini greater than. Enggak. Kalau quadratic inequality, kamu harus bikin x sama dengan dulu. Harus. Ya, please remember that. And then after that, draw the number line. Put the number, negative 2 and 3. And the next question is the curve. Curve-nya gimana? Gini atau gini? Opens up or opens down? Take a look at the x square. The x square is positive. Positive means open down. Ya, jadi di sini kamu gambar opens down. Opens down gitu. Ya. udah gambar opens down, kamu harus shading. Cara shadingnya gimana? Lihat ini. X greater than, sorry, the inequality greater than 0. Tadi greater than 0 itu artinya above the x-axis. Above x-axis itu start dari sini kan? Kalau ini di bawah nih, ini di bawah. Ya. Di atas x-axis itu mulai dari sini ke arah kanan tuh. Dia terus ke kanan ya. Jadi kamu shadingnya tuh dari sini ke arah kanan. Nah ini kamu shade. Tapi ada juga yang di atas above x-axis yang ini nih. Yang di atas x-axis yang sebelah kiri. Jadi yang ini kamu shade ke kiri. Nah, I don't know why, but this method itu agak susah ya. Terutama yang nggak bisa lihat graph itu kasihan, susah banget. Nah, ini cara Cambridge tuh kayak gini. Tapi ada cara lain. Cara lainnya gini guys, gampang. Lihat ya. Test for x equals to 0. Ya, jadi kalau kamu nggak suka pakai cara ini, kita coba pakai cara lain ya. Test for x equals to 0. Masukin ke sini guys. Masukin ke factorization-nya ya. Hasilnya positif atau negatif. Yang kita butuhin cuman positif atau negatif aja. Numbers-nya terserah. Mau berapapun bebas ya. Masukin 0 jadi berapa? Negative 3 ya. 2 ya. Negative 6 ya. We only need the negative ya. And then you have to locate 0 on your number line. Number line-nya ini 0 ada di sini kan? Between negative 2 and 3. And the result is negative tadi. Kamu tulis negatif di sini. Ketika dia loncat satu angka, dia berubah jadi positif. Loncat satu angka, berubah lagi jadi positif. Gitu. Nggak tahu kalau di SMP, diajarinnya gini atau yang tadi. Ada yang masih ingat nggak di SMP diajarinnya gimana? Nah, greater than 0 itu kan artinya positif kan? Kamu shade yang positif. Tuh. Shade yang positif. Nah, satu ke kiri, satu ke kanan. Kalau satu ke kiri, satu ke kanan, pakainya yang atas atau yang bawah?
Yang atas.
Yang atas. Yang atas berarti tulisannya x less than negative 2 or x greater than 3. Gitu. Ya. Yeah. You can take a screenshot for this one if you want. Another example for quadratic inequality. So quadratic inequality is always ya. Kalau I bilang tuh selalu keluar, tapi dia diselipin di chapter lain gitu. Jadi kamu tetap harus bisa ini. Kayak ini. Kayak ini dia diselipin di chapter quadratic equation ya yang ada ininya. Tapi dia selipin ini tuh. Ada less than or more than ya. Hati-hati. Masih ada pertanyaan? Nggak ada. Kalau nggak ada kita langsung ke nomor 7. Nah, nomor 7. Given that a curve has a equation y equals to 1 over x plus 2 square root of x. Find dy over dx. Nah, kemarin di kelas udah tahu sih ya. Di kelas kita udah bahas dy dx itu apa sih? Differentiation, right? So, we have to differentiate this. So, the keyword is dy over dx. Differentiate. Okay? But you cannot differentiate this function. Ada yang tahu kenapa? Kamu nggak bisa. You cannot directly ya. I mean, you cannot directly differentiate this function. Do you know why? Why? When you want to differentiate a function, ya, bentuknya, the form of the function itu have to be powers. Ingat, dia tuh harus powers. Ingat ini ya, ingat kata-kata saya ya. Kalau differentiation itu nggak pernah main akar-akaran guys. Nggak boleh akar. Differentiation itu kalau nggak terpaksa jangan main per-peran. Ya, di soal ini digabungin semua. Waduh, udah jelas nggak bisa ya. Ada pernya, ada akarnya, itu nggak bisa. Kita harus ubah dulu functionnya biar lebih bagus, biar kita bisa langsung differentiate. Yang pertama, 1 over x, kamu harus ubah jadi x to the power of negative 1. So we need the powers. Please remember that when you want to differentiate. plus 2x to the power of half. See, we need the powers, guys. It's very important. So, as long as you can convert the form into powers, you have to do it. Okay, now we can differentiate it directly sekarang ya, karena kita udah ubah bentuknya. Yuk, ada yang masih ingat cara differentiate gimana? X to the power of negative 1, guys. Pangkatnya diapain? Dikedepanin, ya. Move the power to the front, and then minus 1, minus 2. Gitu, gampang. Differentiation tuh gampang ya. Tinggal dikedepanin kurang 1. Kedepanin kurang 1. Selalu gitu. 2 times. Kedepanin pangkatnya, guys. Move the powers to the front. Half times x minus 1. Powersnya dikurang 1. Jadi negatif setengah. Udah selesai. Gimana? Gampang banget ya. Tinggal disimplify sih. X negative 2 plus cross out x to the power of negative 1. You can answer it like this, yeah. But if you want to simplify it, negative 1 over x squared plus 1 over square root x, you can do this also. But I believe not all of you can answer it like this, right? So just leave it like that. Sampai sini udah selesai, udah benar kok. Ya, yeah. Meskipun nanti sama Mark Simnya mungkin ada beda sedikit, nggak apa-apa. Ya, gurunya pasti tahu kok sampai sini udah selesai. Okay, next is this one. What is this? D square y over dx square. What is the meaning of this? Guys, somebody? So, you know that this one is the differentiation, right? The first differentiation. How about this one? The second differentiation. If the third, the powers will be 3. And this one also 3. Yeah, that means the third. The second differentiation means after the first differentiation, you have to differentiate it one more time. So you have to differentiate this one more time, guys. Let's go. Move the powers to the front. So you will get minus, minus 2. And then minus 1 for the powers. Minus it by 1. Negative 2. Minus 1 equals to negative 1. Negative 3, sorry. Negative 3. Gitu ya. And then plus move the powers to the front. And then minus the power with 1. Negative 3 over 2. There you go. Apa tuh? Kenapa tiba-tiba ada suara? Am I disconnected? Guys? Halo? Halo? Can you hear me?
Enggak, sir.
Oh, enggak? No, oke, okay. Tadi ada suara. Ada suara aneh ya.
Enggak,
nah,
sir.
Udah, no, kayak gini. So, bisa this one will be 2 x to the power of negative 3 minus half x to the power of negative 3 over 2. This is the second differentiation, and this one is the first differentiation. Hence, find the coordinates and the nature of stationary point. Okay, so I, we have a keyword, stationary point. What do you do when you read stationary point, guys? Tell me the condition for stationary points. What is the formula? The condition, ya. To be exact, not the formula. The condition for stationary point. Let's go, guys. Baru belajar sama Memrut kemarin. Stationary point. Somebody.
Harus nol, sir.
Apanya?
Harus nol, sir.
Betul sih, harus sama nol. Tapi apanya gitu? Nanti Y-nya dinolin lagi sama kamu ya. Atau X-nya dinolin gitu. Harus sama nol. Apa tuh? The first differentiation. Ya. So, stationary point means the first differentiation have to be equal to 0. Please remember that. This one is also important. Yeah, the first differentiation is negative x to the power of negative 2 plus x to the power of negative half equals to 0. And then after this, your algebra skill will be needed. Yeah, so first, let's simplify this function, it will become negative. Take a look at this. So we have to simplify this function ya. Kalau tadi nggak usah kan, sampai sini aja udah beres gitu. Tapi kalau karena kita mau ngitung, ya ini harus disimplify. Caranya gimana? Take a look at the powers of negative. Do you know that if you have the powers of negative, that means 1 over? Itu harus tahu. Ya, kalau kamu punya pangkat negatif, itu artinya harus udah langsung muncul 1 per. Karena powers negatif itu artinya 1 over. Terus sisanya apa? Sisanya x square. Tulis aja x square. Plus, for this one, you also have negative powers. Negative powers means 1 over yang tadi I bilang. Terus punya over 2. Powersnya itu ada over 2. Itu artinya square root, guys. Sisanya apa? Sisanya x to the power of 1. Gitu. Ya, harus bisa seperti ini. Equals to 0. And then next, let's move the 1 over x square to the right side. You will have an expression like this. Negative become positive. And then maybe cross multiplication. X square equals to square root of x. And then x square divided by square root of x equals to 1 ya. Betul? Pindah lagi si square root of x-nya pindah ke sebelah kiri jadi divide. And then we have to divide them. When you have powers divided by square root, that means kita harus pakai properties of indices ya. Square root itu artinya setengah, bolak-balik ya berarti dari tadi ya. Berarti ini tadi setengahnya harusnya jangan diganti jadi square root, guys. Kalau pengen lebih cepat gini nih. X to the power of half, biarin aja. Ya ini x to the power of half. Ya ini biarin aja x to the power of half. Terus pindah jadi x to the power of half gitu ya. Biarin aja. And then minus it. Please remember that when you divide, the powers should be subtract. Not divide, but subtract. Subtract become 3 over 2 equals to 1. And then 1 to the power of 2 over 3. Nah, ini nggak banyak orang tahu nih. I will give you the shortcut ya. When you have these powers and you want to move the power to the right side, that means you only have to flip the powers. Itu shortcutnya. Ya, cara gampangnya itu kayak gitu. Ya, tinggal di flip aja yang tadi 3 per 2 jadi 2 per 3 gitu. Oke? Okay? Nah, satu pangkat berapapun, 1 to the power of something, anything, itu hasilnya pasti 1. Nah, kita dapat teksnya 1. Any questions for this one? Four mark, guys. It's worth. But not finished yet. Ya. The question says point. Tuh, kata I juga harus baca soalnya. Ya. Kita udah dapat tuh harus baca lagi. Point. Point means X and Y. Right? Ini ada yang mau nanya nih. Siapa yang mau nanya? Ada yang mikrofonnya kebuka? Halo, halo. Ada yang bocor nih.
Oh, sorry, sir.
Ya. Nggak mau nanya tadi?
Oh, sorry, sir.
Kepencet ya?
Itu teh ya. X pangkat 2 minus setengah.
Itu teh X pangkat 2.
X pangkat 2 minus.
Ya, betul. X pangkat 2 minus
setengah, sir. Dapat 3 per 2.
Ya, because it's division, right? When you divide something, you have to subtract the powers. Oke, ada lagi pertanyaan? Nggak ada? Oke, kita baca point ya. Point itu harus ada X, harus ada Y. We have to find the value of Y to get the point, to get the coordinates. So now, after we have the X, we have to find the Y, right? We want to find the Y, not the Y over the X. The common mistakes you do is, karena tadi kalian lagi ngomongin dy dx, kebanyakan dari kalian tuh masukin satunya ke dy dx, guys. Don't. Ya, kenapa? Karena kita lagi cari y, kan? X and y. Not x and dy over dx. Bukan gitu, kan? Kita carinya y. Jadi kita masukinnya ke y, guys. Y equals to 1 over x plus 2 square root of x. When x equals to 1, it will be 1 over 1, 2 square root of 1, and you will get 3. And the point, the stationary point is, the stationary point is 1,3. There you go. This is how you find stationary point. But the question want us to find the nature also. Nature, guys. The keyword, the next keyword is nature. When you read nature of the stationary points, you have to remember something. What is it? Hey guys, nature of stationary points. If d square y over dx square greater than 0, means the nature is minimum. If the d square y over the dx square less than 0, that means the nature is maximum. Gitu. Ya, ini harus dihafalin. Okay. Now, let's take a look at the d square y. We already got before. D square y over d square dx square equals to 2x to the power of negative 3 minus half x to the power of negative 3 over 2. Substitute the x. When x equals to 1, the value of d square y over dx square will be 2 times 1 to the power of negative 3 minus half times 1 to the power of negative over 2 equals to 3 over 2. And 3 over 2 is greater than 0. We know that 3 over 2 is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means the nature will be minimum. So this is the stationary point and the nature is minimum. There you go. This is number 7. 8 marks. Easy questions. 8 marks, yeah. Very worth it. Easy questions, guys. Why I tell you this one is easy? Because you only have to put it into the formula. You don't have to think. Ya, kamu gak usah mikir, aduh, dicari apa dulu ya? Enggak. Kamu tinggal ikutin alurnya, cari formulanya apa, masukin semua, dapat. Gitu ya. And stationary point usually comes out in IGCSE also. Ya, karena ini soal IGCSE ya, banyak banget stationary point. Any question for number 7? No? Okay, next is number 8. For number 8, we have the rate. The variable x and y are related by the equation y equals to x plus 1 times x cubed. Given that x is increasing at rate of 0.2 radian per second, and the corresponding rate of change of y when x equals to 2 is, this one is 6 mark, yeah, but it's so easy, guys. Let's go. Let's do this. First, I want to write the function. The function is x plus 1 times x cubed. But I want to multiply it first to get the simplest form of the y. So we have x to the power of 4 plus x to the power of 3 for the function. And then after that, read this one, guys. X is increasing at rate 0.2. We don't need the unit, yeah. Just read the x is increasing at rate 0.2. When you read this one, increasing at point rate, at rate, decreasing at rate, what? Itu kamu harus tahu nulisnya apa, guys. Atau mungkin pertama kali kamu harus tahu chapternya apa ya. Chapternya apa? Increasing at rate. Decreasing at rate. Itu differentiation. Differentiation yang small change, kalau nggak salah judulnya apa ya? Rate of change ya, judulnya rate of change yang ada di buku tebal kamu yang rate of change. If you read x is increasing at rate, kau baca rate itu langsung dx over dt, guys. Harus bisa langsung tulis gitu, begitu kamu baca rate dx over dt. Kalau kamu bacanya y rate dy over dt, when you read area rate dA over dt. Selalu kayak gitu. So dx over dt equals to 0.2. The question give you the value. Next, read this one. rate of change of y. So the question wants you to find dy over dt when x equals to 2. Okay, so this is the given information. Let's write the formula, guys. What is the formula for this one? Yang ada dy over dt, dx over dt. Ada yang ingat? Ada yang ingat? Ayo, baru kemarin nih kayaknya. Chapter terakhir kayaknya yang Memrod ajarin ya. Jadi harusnya masih ingat, guys. Apa formulanya? It start with dy over dt, guys. Let's go. One, two, three, four, five. Aduh, nggak ada yang ingat satu pun. Satu anak aja. Ini kayaknya lagi buka buku catatan ya. Langsung cepet-cepet buka catatan ya. Mending ada catatan ya. Kalau nggak ada catatannya, buka dulu colanya. Waduh, gawat itu ya. So, the formula is dy over dx times dx over dt, guys. You have to memorize this formula. Okay? And then next, because the question is dy over dt, we will leave the dy over dt like that. And then dy over dx. Dy over dx means the first differentiation, right? First differentiation. So we have to differentiate this. Differentiate it. What will it become? 4, move to the front, minus 1, 4x cubed. 3, move to the front, 3x squared. There you go. This is the first differentiation. Times with 0.2, right? For dx over dt, it's 0.2. Oh, yeah. I forget to tell you something. When the question says increasing, you have to write 0.2 positive. But if the question says decreasing, you have to write it negative 0.2. Yeah, please remember that. So because this one is increasing, I will write it as 0.2. If you read decreasing, you have to put negative in front of the numbers. Dah? Nah, kalau udah, tinggal masukin y-nya. Dy over dt equals to 4 times 2. Because the question wants you to find the dy over dt when x equals to 2. You can substitute the x with 2. Like this. Times 0.2. And finally, you'll get the answer. 6 mark for this one. Wow. Itu untung banget sih ya. Kalau I bilang hoki banget sih. Kalau kalian dapat soal ini nanti di mock exam. Itu hoki banget, guys. Ini gampang banget. 8 times 4. 32. 32 plus 12. 44. Times 0.2. 8.8 ya. There you go. You can write your answer as 8.8, or you can you can write the unit also, radian per second. But I don't think you should write the unit ya. Unitnya kadang-kadang berubah, guys. Udah biarin aja 8.8. Tergantung fungsinya ya. Nanti kalian nggak ngerti lagi. Dapat unitnya dari mana? Udah tulis aja 8.8. Nggak akan disalahin kok. That is for number 8. Any questions, guys? Two numbers left. Questions? Can you understand that? Easy ya. Okay, next is number 9. Oh ya, kalau kalian lagi sial, dapat soal nomor 8-nya tuh yang soal cerita, guys. Word problems. Word problems di chapter ini tuh susah banget ya. Jadi kalian nanti kita belajar lah ya. Nanti kita belajar. Tapi semoga nanti di mock exam yang pertama ini nggak ada word problems-nya dulu untuk yang ini ya. Semoga mirip kayak gini. Kalau ada word problems itu harus pakai logika. Number 9. Sequence. Sequence kemarin belajar sama I nih. Yo, masih ingat nggak formulanya apa ya? Ada arithmetic sequence, ada geometric sequence. The first term of a series is 6. So write the information first. U1 equals to 6. Or maybe you can say A. Yeah, the first term it's A. And the second term is 2. U2 equals to 2. For the case where the series is an arithmetic progression, katanya. Find the sum of the first 80 terms. gampang banget gitu. Dia tanya apa? The sum of the first 80 terms. Ya, dia tanya SAT, guys. SAT, formulanya apa? N over 2, 2A plus N minus 1 times the difference, right? N-nya 80, A-nya udah punya 6, N-nya 80 lagi, sama difference-nya. Nah, difference-nya belum punya, guys. Kita cari dulu difference-nya. Difference equals to 2 minus 6 equals to negative 4. So, the difference is negative 4. Next, 40 times 12. Susah ini ya, sebagai calculator, guys. 280 plus 36. 316 minus 316 gitu. 280 plus 36. Ya, oke. Okay. Ya, udah gak tau lah ini. Harus pakai calculator ya. Negatif 304 kali 40. Negatif 12160. Nah, ini answernya. SAT. Oke, okay, next is II. II katanya geometric ya. Kalau geometric berarti kita cari R-nya dulu. R equals to the second term divided by the first term. 1 over 3. Do you still remember what is the sum of infinity? The formula? The formula? Because I forget, guys. If I forget, we cannot continue. I know you remember this. Just unmute your microphone and tell me. That's not hard. Please unmute your microphone and tell me, guys. I forget the formula. We cannot continue if we forget the formula. You have to remember.
A per 1 minus R.
Okay, very good. A over 1 minus R, ya.
A per 1
minus
R.
So the answer will be A. A-nya itu 6. Masih sama kayak yang tadi, ya. Cuman kali ini geometric katanya. 1 over 3, 6 over 2 over 3, and the question, the answer is 9. There you go. Huh, cepet ya kita bikinnya ya. 10, berapa nomor nih? Udah mau 7 nomor ya, 7 nomor cuman sejam. Ya, lama sih ya, tapi kan sambil jelasin. Harusnya 1 jam setengah. 11 sampai 12 nomor sih ya kalau bikin sendiri. And the last one. Any questions for number 9? No? It's very easy sih number 9 ya. Number 10, solve. So now we go to apa ini namanya? Trigonometric equation. Oke, okay, trigonometric equation. Nah, ini sama Memrut di semester 1 ya. Nah, saya nggak tahu diajarin metodenya kayak gimana. Tapi saya ajarin metode saya aja ya. Nomor 10A. We have 4 sin x equals to cosecant. Do not use cosecant, secant, cotangent. It's little bit hard. Oke? Okay? Kecuali terpaksa. Ya, kayak nomor B. Ya, nomor B itu terpaksa pakai secant. Tapi kalau nggak terpaksa, ubah aja. Cosecant itu 1 over sin, right? 1 over sin diubah, terus cos multiply, you will have 4 sin square x equals to 1, and then you will have sin square x equals to 1 over 4, and then I will have sin x equals to square root of 1 over 4, sin x equals to half. Am I right? Guys, am I right? Am I right? Am I right?
It should be plus or minus.
Ah, very good. Oke, okay, good. Ya, ada yang tahu ya. Kalau square, kalau kamu pindahin square jadi square root, do not forget the plus minus. Please remember that, ya. Don't forget the plus minus. Oke, okay, so you have sin x equals to plus minus half. That means sin x equals to half. And that means sin x equals to negative half. For this one, I know that you didn't have to memorize the table, so you can use your calculator. I will teach you how to solve this using calculator ya. First, I want you to take your calculator and then change the setup into degree. Please remember that when you want to press sine, cos, and tan, you have to set up your calculator first. Change your setup into degree, guys. And then press sine to the power of negative 1 and half. What will you get? What do you get? How many?
30.
Very good. 30 degree. Okay, good. So, we know that in trigonometry, 36. The quadrant is very important, right? So, we have to draw the quadrant. We know that the first one is all sine, tan, and cos, all positive. Sine positive, tan positive, and cos positive. Yeah, this is 0 degree, 90, 180, 270, and also 360. And we got 30 as the first result. Yeah, that means 30 is right here. And the sine is positive, right? Sine x equals to positive. So that means we have to move this 3. Kita harus pindahin nih. Kita harus pindahin 3 ini ke another quadrant. Yeah, jadi kamu jangan jawab tulis X sama dengan 30 derajat aja. Jangan ya, karena ada answer yang lain. Nah, cara dapetin answer yang lainnya itu, pindahin 30 derajatnya ke kuadran yang lain. Yang sine-nya positif, guys. Kita maunya lagi ngomongin soal sine positif. Berarti pindahin 30-nya ke sine yang positif, ke kuadran 2. Pindahin ke kuadran 2. 30 pindah ke kuadran 2, caranya tuh 180 kurang 30. Sama dengan 150. Jadi jawaban yang pertama itu ada 30 sama 150, guys. Ngerti nggak? Ya, jadi kamu nggak boleh jawab 30 aja. Di kalkulator memang tulisannya 30 aja, karena dia nggak mungkin show 150, nggak mungkin. Ya, kalkulator kamu tuh pasti jawabnya 30 aja. Tapi kamu harus tahu, kamu harus pakai kuadrannya. Kamu harus pindahin 30-nya ke 150. Oke, kalau nggak ngerti nggak apa-apa, kita coba lagi yang ini. Nah, untuk yang ini hati-hati guys. Ketika kamu tulis sine inverse, itu triknya adalah jangan tulis negatifnya guys. Tulisnya setengah tetap. Dapatnya 30 lagi kan. Nah, setengah ini buat apa? Buat kuadran. Jadi kamu dapatnya 30. Dan 30 ini semuanya positif kan? Berarti ini not valid. Ini tuh not valid. X-nya tuh nggak boleh kamu tulis 30, nggak boleh. Meskipun di kalkulator kamu tulisannya 30 ya. Karena kamu tadi masukinnya positif setengah. Nah, 30 ini basic angle namanya. Kalau di buku itu namanya basic angle. Basic angle ini harus dipindahin ke kuadran yang sine-nya negatif. Sekarang kita lagi ngomongin sine-nya negatif half. Berarti pindahin ke kuadran 3 sama pindahin ke kuadran 4, guys. Nah, 30 ini harus pindah ke sini sama harus pindah ke sini. Gimana caranya? Please remember that when you move an angle from quadrant 1 to another quadrant, patokannya itu cuma boleh dipakai 180 sama 360, guys. You cannot use 90 and 270. Ya, yeah. The one that you can use is only 180 and 360. You cannot use another else. Oke, okay, jadi 30 pindah ke kuadran 3 itu berarti 210. Dapat dari mana 210? 180 tambah 30. Ya, tahu dari mana ditambah, bukan dikurang. Tahu dari mana? Pilihannya kan cuma 2. 180 tambah 30 atau 180 kurang 30. Ya, tahu dari mana ditambah? Ya, karena kuadran 3 itu more than 180. Jadi mau nggak mau ditambah. Oke, okay. Kalau 360, kalau pindahin ke kuadran 4, berarti 360 dikurang 30, ya, karena kuadran 4 itu less than 360, so you have to minus it, 330. Nah, dari yang sini kamu dapat 210 sama 330. Nah, jadi jawabannya, totalnya adalah X equals to 30 150, 210, and 330. There you go. But do not forget to check the boundaries. The boundaries is from 0 until 360, ya. And our answer also from 0 until 360. So all of our answer is valid. This is 10A. Ini susah malah 3 answer 3 mark doang ya. Ini enggak worth it sih. Ini enggak worth it. Can you understand this? Mau latihan lagi mindah-mindahin angle? Yuk, kita latihan lagi mindah-mindahin angle yuk. So for example, I have 60 right here. When you move 60 to the second quadrant, what will it become? 60 derajat di kuadran 1 nih. Mau dipindahin ke kuadran 2 jadi berapa? Waduh, belum pada ngerti semuanya? Nggak ada? Nggak bisa satupun? Ingat, patokannya itu 360 sama 180 ya. Jadi pilihannya tinggal ditambah atau dikurang. Jadi kalau 60 di kuadran 1, saya pindahin ke kuadran 2. Kalau basic angle-nya 60, pindah ke kuadran 2 jadi berapa? Ini nggak ngerti atau nggak mau jawab. Gimana dong? Kalau ke kuadran 3 jadi berapa? 180 tambah 60. Kalau ke kuadran 4 jadi berapa? 360 kurangi 60, 300. Gitu ya. Mau lagi? Lagi? Mau cobain lagi? Nih, kalau 10 derajat di kuadran 1, pindah ke kuadran 2 jadi berapa?
170.
Kuadran 3?
190.
190. Kuadran 4? 350. Ya, gitu ya. 190. Jadi kalian harus bisa ini semua ya. Dan satu lagi. When you have sin x equals to negative half, please remember this. Don't use negative half in your calculator ya. But instead half. Halfnya aja. Kalau negative half, okay sih. Ini lihat ya. Kalau kamu masukin negative half di calculator, dia tuh jawabannya negative 30 guys. Nah ini bingung kamu langsung. Tapi kalau kamu masukin half, kamu bisa dapat 30-nya dulu. Nanti tinggal pakai kuadrannya gitu. Ngerti nggak? Jadi kalau ada negatif, jangan masukin. Ya, please remember that. Next is 10B. Ini kenapa ya loncat-loncat terus. Next is 10B. The last one. Okay, now we have 10 square, guys. After the 10 square, we have second square. Nah, usually when you face, apa ini namanya? Trigonometric equations problems. Ada square-nya, itu biasanya pakai let. You have to let tan 3y equals to like x gitu or anything else. Yeah. But for these questions, you cannot let the square directly with the another letters. Yeah. You cannot let the equations right now. You have to make the equations the same first. Jadi kalau kamu pakainya tan, ya semuanya harus tan. Kalau sekan, ya semuanya harus sekan. Kalau sin, semuanya harus sin. Baru bisa di let, gitu ya. Biar sama permisalannya. Nah, untuk yang ini kita pakai properties dulu. Pakai identity dulu. We have this type of identity. 1 tan square x equals to sekan square x, right? 1 plus tan square x equals to second square x. Nah, tapi di sini kan tan-nya 3y. Kita ganti aja rumusnya sedikit. 1 plus tan 3y equals to second square 3y. Oke. Satunya saya pindahin ke sini. Jadi formulanya kita modif dulu. Second square 3y minus 1. And that means I can change this tan square 3y into second square 3y minus 1. Do you agree? Berarti, sir, harus hafal identitinya. Iya dong, identity semua harus. Pokoknya semua formula yang dari SMP sampai SMA harus hafal ya. Cara ngafalinnya gimana, sir? Saya harus buka buku lagi atau gimana? Enggak, kamu nggak usah buka buku lagi. Untuk yang pertama, mock exam yang pertama, ya kamu harus buka buku. Oke? Atau cari di internet. at mat IGCSE notes gitu ya. Kalau nggak salah ada di Z Notes gitu, kalau nggak salah websitenya Z Notes atau apa gitu. Tapi banyak sih website yang nyediain rumus-rumus tuh, banyak banget. Kamu tinggal cari di internet ya. Oke, okay, so after this. Tapi nanti lama-lama kalau kamu udah sering bikin past papers, bikin 2 kali, 3 kali, 4 kali, 5 kali, 6 kali, 10 kali, nanti lama-lama rumusnya hafal sendiri kok. Ya, nggak usah khawatir. Untuk pertama nggak hafal nggak apa-apa. Second square x minus 2 second. Nah, sekarang udah second semua, guys. Kalau udah second semua, baru kita bisa let. Let second 3y as a, misalnya. Jadi di sini dia berubah jadi a square. The next is 2a minus 3 equals to 0. It will become quadratic equation. When you have quadratic equation, of course, you have to factorize. A, 3, and 2, minus, no, 1, 3 and 1, ya. Minus, and, yeah, okay. So, A equals to 3, and A equals to negative 1. After that, do not forget to revert the A into second 3y. Second 3y equals to 3, and second 3y equals to negative 1. Like I told you before, do not use secant, cosecant, and cotangent. It will be hard. Yeah, so you have to change this one into 1 over cos. We know that secant is 1 over cos, right? 1 over cos equals to 3, and then cross multiply, 1 equals to 3 equals 3 times cos 3y, so you will get cos 3y equals to 1 over 3. And then after that, for this one, we have 1 over cos 3y equals to negative 1. So when you cross multiply, you will get negative cos 3y. I will have cos 3y equals to negative 1. So we have two value for cos 3y. Okay, next is 3y and 3y equals to. Use your calculator, guys. Cos inverse, you will write cos inverse 1 over 3. What is the answer?
70.5, sir.
1 over 3. 70.5. 1 over 3, ya? 70.5. Okay, good. 70.5. So the answer is 70.5. Please remember that this answer always the basic angle. Jadi dia tuh masih di kuadran 1. Nah, kita lihat cos y-nya itu positif, right? Positif 1 over 3. Jadi kita harus pindahin 70,5 ini ke yang kuadrannya positif untuk cos, which is kuadran 4. Positifnya tuh di kuadran 1 sama kuadran 4, ya. Berarti kuadran 1 udah termasuk results. 70.5, koma, pindahin ke kuadran 4, guys. Tadi udah diajarin caranya 360 minus 70.5. Itu 289.5. Ya, kalau kamu udah terbiasa sama cara yang diajarin Memrut juga boleh pakai, ya. Sama aja kok. Sama aja caranya, ya. Udah? Nah, udah dua ini. Tinggal yang sebelah sini, guys. Cos inverse, don't use 1. But instead, 1. Berapa? Cos inverse 1? 0. 0. Oke. 0, ya. 0 itu basic angle. Basic angle selalu ada di kuadran 1. Dia maunya yang negatif 1, guys. Negatif 1 itu ada di kuadran 2 sama kuadran 3 untuk cos. Jadi kita harus pindahin. 0-nya not valid, ya. Not valid. Karena dia positif. Kuadran 1 itu positif. Berarti dia not valid. Kita harus pindahin 0-nya ke kuadran 2, guys. Jadi berapa? -180 Kita harus pindahin 0-nya ke kuadran 3, guys. Karena cos-nya di sana negatif. Kita butuh cos yang negatif. Kuadran 3, 180 plus 0. Oh, sama aja, ya. 180, ya. Yaudah, satu aja. Nggak ada lagi. Kalau udah, tinggal cari y-nya. Y equals to 70.5 divided by 3. 23.5. 289.5 divided by 3. 96.5. For this one, y equals to 60. Okay, this is our answer, but do not forget to check the boundaries. The boundaries for this one is from 0, y is from 0 until 180, guys. From 0 until 180. Kalau nggak salah, kamu diajarinnya gini ya. Ini kita kali 3 dulu ya. 3y less than or equal to 540. Jadi kita tahu 3y-nya itu harus sampai 540, kan? Nah, tadi kita dapetinnya itu baru segini. Baru 70. 3y-nya itu baru 70. Baru segini. Sedangkan dia harus sampai 540. Berarti kurang. Sorry. Kalau kurang, apa yang kamu lakuin? Gampang, guys. Tinggal tambahin 360 plus 360. Tambahin satu putaran. Berarti 360 tambah 70,5. 430,5. Kalau yang 289 udah kelebihan dari 540, berarti nggak usah. Ya. Bagi lagi, 430,5 bagi 3. Hasilnya 143,5. Yang 180 masih bisa nggak ditambah 360? Masih bisa. Jawabannya 540 itu. Pas kan? 540 bagi 3 lagi. Bagi 3 berapa tuh? 180. Dah. Nah, ini jawabannya. Jawabannya itu berarti y equals to we have 23.5, we have 60, we have 96.5, we have 143.5. We have 180. There you go. Kalau kata saya yang paling susah tuh yang ini, guys. Dari nomor 1 sampai nomor 10 paling susah ini sih. 10B. Pasti nggak ngerti ya. 10B ya. Hah? Mau sekali lagi? Different questions? Okay, let's try this one more time ya. Let's try second sin aja deh. Sin square 2x ya. Sin square 2x plus 2 sin x minus 8. Not 8. Oh, di sini harus ada duanya ya. Di sini 2. Di sininya coba 3 deh. Saya harus bikin dulu, ntar ya. 2x minus 1 and x plus 2. 2x square plus 3x minus 2. Oke, okay, let's go. Nah, yang kayak gini, terus boundaries-nya dari 0 sampai 360 ya. Oke, okay, yuk. Gimana caranya nih? Kita kayak tadi lagi. Pertama, kamu lihat dulu. Di sini udah sin 2x sama sin 2x ya, udah sama. Berarti bisa langsung let sin 2x equals to 8. Ya, bareng-bareng yuk, biar kamu bisa. Bareng-bareng, yang ini jadi apa? Jadi apa? 2. Guys. Kalau kamu nggak jawab, nanti nggak bisa-bisa loh.
2a
square plus
3a
minus 2.
2a square, sir.
Ya. Oke, sekali lagi guys, kalau yang ada 3A. Acara sama keluarga ya, kalian boleh leave aja, nggak usah pamit, nggak apa-apa. Langsung aja leave. One more time, this extra lesson is not compulsory. If you have any acara sama keluarga, ya kamu boleh pergi ya. Nggak apa-apa, yuk langsung aja leave. Tapi jangan terpaksa di sini ya, jangan terpaksa. Nah, tapi kalau diminta jawab, tolong jawab ya. Yuk, next is you have to factorize, right? I will factorize it for you. 2a and a. This one is 2. 1. Plus, minus ya. So, you will get a equals to half. And you will get a equals to negative 2. Udah? Nah, kalau udah, kita separate. And then, revert the a back to sine 2x. Sine 2x equals to half. And for this one, sine 2x equals to negative 2. For the second answer, ini tuh langsung di reject, guys. Ini langsung cannot. Atau no solution. Ada yang tahu kenapa no solution? Ada yang tahu kenapa ini no solution? Ada yang tahu kenapa ini no solution? Karena sin itu paling tingginya 1, guys. Paling rendahnya min 1. Dia nggak bisa min 2. Dia nggak bisa 2. Dia nggak bisa 1.5. Dia nggak bisa 4. Dia nggak bisa 3. Jadi kalau kamu dapat kayak sin x sama dengan 5, ini udah nggak bisa aja. Sin x sama dengan min 3, ini nggak bisa aja gitu. Ya, karena dia paling tingginya 1, paling rendahnya min 1. Itu harus dihafalin. Jadi ini no solution. Jadi kita fokusnya ke sini aja. Oke, tadi caranya gimana? Ambil kalkulator kalian, tulis sin inverse half. Tulis sin inverse half, guys. Dapatnya berapa?
30.
Okay, very good. 30 is the basic angle. It's always in quadrant 1. Semua angka yang kamu dapat dari kalkulator itu pasti ada di quadrant 1. Take a look at the sign. The sign is positive. Sign positive. Ya, berarti 30 derajatnya jawaban yang valid. Kenapa? Kuadran 1 itu sinnya positif ya. Dia termasuk ke dalam jawaban. Langsung kamu tulis 2x. Masih 2x ya. Soalnya 2x. 2x equals to 30 degree, guys. Udah termasuk ke dalam jawaban. Tapi ada lagi jawaban yang lain. Kita harus pindahin. Nah, saya mau tanya. 30 derajat ini harus dipindahin ke kuadran mana? Kuadran 2, kuadran 3, atau kuadran 4? Clue-nya itu dari sini nih, dari positif. Sin-nya itu harus positif, guys. Kuadran yang sin-nya positif, kuadran berapa? Bareng-bareng yuk. Jangan saya mau udah tahu jawabannya ya. Justru saya tanya kalian, biar kaliannya bisa jawab. Besok, seandainya keluar soal nih. Harus dipindahin ke kuadran berapa?
2, sir.
Kuadran 2, oke. Okay. Kita pindahin ke kuadran 2 ke sini. 30-nya pindah ke kuadran 2, jadi hasilnya berapa?
2, sir.
150, ya. Nah, tadi alasan dipindahin ke kuadran 2 kenapa? Karena kuadran 2 sinnya bernilai positif. Ya. Jadi kita pindahin ke kuadran 2. Jangan ke kuadran 3. Kalau ke kuadran 3 sinnya itu negatif. Kuadran 4 sinnya juga negatif. Jangan. Ya. Jadi kita pindahin ke kuadran 2. So we have two answers from this one. 30 and 150. Ya. Terus kita cek cukup atau enggak. Cara cek cukup atau enggak dari sini. Kalau kita bikin jadi 2x, ini kan x nih. Kalau kita bikin jadi 2x, itu jadinya 720 kan. Jadi 2x-nya itu paling besarnya harus 720. Sedangkan kita tadi bikin baru sampai 150 kan. 2x-nya itu baru sampai 150. Dia harus sampai 720 loh. Berarti masih kurang. Betul nggak? Kalau masih kurang, apa yang kamu lakuin? Tadi saya bilang apa? Tambahin satu putaran, 360. So you will have 390. Ini juga tambahin lagi satu putaran, tambah 360 lagi. So you will have 510. Duh, ini masih 720 kan? Masih jauh. Tambahin lagi, guys. Tambahin lagi 360. Berapa tuh? 750. Tapi udah kelebihan ya. Dia kan tadi maunya mentoknya di 720 kan. Kalau 750 udah kelebihan. Oh berarti udah cukup. Sampai sini aja. Kalau udah baru dibagi 2 semua. Kita cari X-nya. X equal to 30 divided by 2. 15. 75. 145. No. 195. And then 255. This is the answer for this one. Itu ya. Nah, buat kalian latihan ya. Boleh. Kenapa?
Yang enggak boleh lebih dari 720T 2x.
Sorry. Ya, 2x.
Yang enggak boleh dari Yang gak boleh lebih dari 720 2x, bukannya x.
Kalau 2x gak boleh lebih dari 720. Ya, okay, ngerti? Ada lagi? Gak ada? Nah, nanti.
Okay,
ya, ya, kenapa?
Will we get the formula in the text? Because in the past paper you gave us, like, there's the formula in the front.
Will we get the formula in the text?
Nah, because
in
the past paper you gave us, like, there's the formula in the front. I don't know whether she put the formula in the first page or what, gitu, or the last page. I don't know because I haven't seen the question paper. So okay. I'm so sorry, I cannot tell you. Okay. Maybe you can chat Memrut and ask her whether she give you the formula or not.
Okay, thank you. Okay.
Okay. Next question.
Okay.
No more questions? Okay, I think that's it for today. I hope that